The supreme leader of North Korea, some call him. Some people say he's one of the most dangerous people in the world, and truth is, there is a lot that we do not know about the North Korean dictator who rules his country with an iron fist. North Korea has such a strict policy on letting information spill out of the country that we barely know anything. We can only really speculate on what is going on with him and the country, but there are still a few stories that have slipped out, and they are some of the most outlandish claims that you can hear about a person. I'm your host, Chay Arena, and this is Life's Biggest Questions. On today's episode, we are going to be looking at some of the legends that have been created surrounding Kim Jong-un. This is our list of top 10 scary Kim Jong-un urban legends. As always, I would love it if you guys could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. And also stick around until the end of the video because I am going to be giving you the answer to this riddle. I speak without a mouth, I hear without ears, I have no body, but I come alive with the wind. What am I? If you think you know the answer, hit up the comment section now and write down your answer, and I will reveal the real answer at the end of the video. Without taking any longer, let's get into this list. At number 10, he's an international celebrity. Of course, we all know who Kim Jong-un is, so in a way, he is a celebrity, but we see him almost as a monster you should be afraid of, like the boogeyman. That's why we all know who he is, not because he's on the cover of Us Weekly like a lot of the people in North Korea think. North Koreans are told that Kim Jong-un is one of the most beloved celebrities in the world, that no matter where he travels, he's greeted with open arms, that when he arrives, large parties are thrown for him, and probably the craziest thing, that every other country around the world celebrates his birthday. Could you imagine something like that? We don't even celebrate our own ruler's birthdays, let alone the birthday of some bloodthirsty dictator from another country. Like, just picture it, you and all your friends get together for a Kim Jong-un party like it was New Year's Eve. What a twisted, upside-down world that would be. I'm sure if there's another universe where that's a reality, it's a really fun time, yeah. At number 9, we have Kim Jong-un is the world's greatest scientist. I can't say it without laughing. Here's the thing with all these rumors that leak out of the country. I wonder how many people actually believe them, or how many people think they're just made up and pretend that they believe them because they don't want the government to come to their home and take them away to a labor camp. Now, this claim is absolutely insane. The North Korean people are told that Kim Jong-un worked with a team of North Korean scientists to make a super drug, literally the cure-all for anything that could possibly make you sick. Do you have any sort of venereal disease? Well, this magical drug can cure it. Did you get cancer? This can cure it. Did you catch Ebola while you were having a seizure and you also have a staph infection? Well, this can cure all of that as well as aging. The cure is apparently made from rare earth elements, and I guess he's going to have to explain to his people why he didn't use his own miracle drug and opted for open heart surgery instead. Well, he could tell his people if he's not dead, we don't know yet. At number 8, we have Kim Jong-un mended the Japanese occupation. Japan and Korea have a long history of being enemies. One of the darkest times in their history was when Japan occupied Korea in 1919. I won't get into too much detail because we came to talk about the Big Un, but if you want to look back at some heart-wrenching stories from history, then this is a perfect time to go back and check. Now, this has created a long-standing hatred between all of Korea, not just North or South, with Japan. And Kim Jong-un has said to fix this problem by turning back time itself. Because the Japanese came and took time from the Koreans, Kim Jong-un turned back the clocks a half hour to give Koreans more time, so everyone will live a half hour longer. Now, here's what I have to say about that. Even if that was true, giving everyone just half an hour extra doesn't really make up for all the atrocities that were committed during the 1919 occupation. You gotta give them way more than that. At least give them one of your abilities or a new car or something. At number 7, we have he knows nothing about the West. Even though we don't know a lot about him, he knows a lot about us. In fact, Kim Jong-un, his sister, and his brother all lived outside of North Korea in their youth. There has been evidence that shows they attended a school in Germany as well as Switzerland. He lived outside of North Korea for most of his youth, and why, nobody knows. This could have been a safety thing. Kim Jong-il might have feared that his kids were going to get assassinated or kidnapped and wanted them to be safe under a different name in a different country. Some people think that he was living outside the country in case his father wanted to defect or to gain intel on what the outside world looks like so he could have better control over his people and interact with world leaders properly. But just so you know, he probably grew up watching the same cartoons as you. At number 6, he is a master behind the wheel. What age do you think it's safe for someone to take wheel of a vehicle? You probably want to wait until until you're at least 16, and even then, I don't really think any teenager should be on the road. That being said, you grow up in the suburbs and you're bored all the time, I can understand you want to get out as fast as possible. Well, the glorious leader Kim Jong-un didn't have to wait that long. Apparently, he could masterfully control a car from the age of 3. They say as a toddler, he was a better driver than everyone outside of North Korea. Yeah, you know all the rally car drivers and the Formula One drivers, he could drive circles around those guys, I'm sure, for sure. It's insane if people believe this. On top of that, they say once he was a master of anything with 4 wheels, he was so bored with that it was time to move on to the sea. When he was only 9 years old, the spherical leader went on to learn how to sail and became one of the world's greatest captains. Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if this guy didn't know how to swim. At number 5, we have he climbed the highest mountain. There's a massive mountain in North Korea. It stands at 922 feet, and it's called Paekku Mountain. Well, everyone believes that the glorious leader climbed the mountain without the help of anyone. Frankly, he probably didn't even get changed into workout clothes based on the stuff we have said so far. And if you don't believe this, well, the legend says that there were hundreds of fighter pilots that flew to the top of the mountain because they couldn't keep pace with his walking, and all of those people saw it and said that it's true, so it has to be true. There has to be someone who looks at that portly boy and says there's no way he worked his way all the way up that mountain. That guy probably can't even touch his toes. He's so perfectly round that if he lost his footing climbing up that mountain, he would roll all the way to the bottom like that wheel of cheese they throw down that hill in the people chase. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? The wheel of cheese thing? Well, all I'm saying is that there's no way this guy is doing any sort of physical feat, especially not one like that. At number 4, we have everyone watches his movies. There are several North Korean-made movies starring Kim Jong-un that the people of North Korea are forced to watch regularly. It's almost good that they don't have any other forms of media. Could you imagine knowing that Ozark exists, but you have to sit down and watch a Kim Jong-un movie? Oh my god, with this terrible acting, every movie plot being about how amazing he is, that would be terrible. Well, he has claimed that it's not just the people of North Korea that love to watch these movies, but everyone else around the world as well, that we all watch these movies all the time. Sorry, dude, no thank you. We are not interested in watching any of the lie-filled, poorly shot, poorly scripted movies that you are cranking out on your side of the world. I'm sticking to watching Parasite. At number 3, we have he is the youngest military mastermind. This was a myth that his father started about himself and has been carried down to his son. They believe that Kim Jong-un is the greatest military mind that has ever lived. He could conquer any country he wanted just with his thoughts. That every country knows this and he lets them live the way that they want because he wishes to be a peaceful man. I wonder what the shock is for these people when they leave their country and defect to somewhere else. When they finally find out that no one really respects him and some people fear him, but only because he threatens to launch nukes almost every other day, not because he's some sort of genius. At number 2, we have he's generous with his power. We all see him as a ruthless monster, but many people in their country think he is an all-powerful person and very kind. A way he shows his kindness is by gifting some of his all-powerful energy to other people, mainly those of the North Korean athletes. He is able to empower them to make them play better, and through this they are able to win every gold medal at the Olympics and even the World Cup. That is right, everyone in North Korea thinks that they are the best international competitors and we struggle to play against them in every sport. I mean, like, even hockey? There's no way that someone sees hockey and goes, oh yeah, we're good at that too. There's no way the people in North Korea think that they can beat everyone at hockey? No, there has to be a line, and I think that's it. And for the number one spot, we have Kim Jong-un is the founder of a unicorn. To start off, I'm surprised that Kim Jong-un even lets his people think that this mythical creature exists. I thought it would seem way too Western for his taste. Well, not only does he let his people think that it's real, but he also told them that he found one. I know this seems like the craziest thing of all time, but I am not joking at all. He claims that he worked with a team of archaeologists and went searching in the mountains of North Korea. During this mission, they came across a cave which had a beautiful unicorn in it. Now, some people were probably like, well, can we get a picture of this? And they were quickly executed. And if you're wondering how he is able to keep everyone in his country under such control, well, no one has internet. The only people who have access to internet are government officials, as well as his family. So when you can't Google anything and all your books are vetted by a dictatorship, it can be very hard to break away and discover what the rest of the world is like. Alright guys, that's all we have for you today on Life's Biggest Questions. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Be sure to hit up the comment section and let me know what you thought about the video, and let us guys know what you would like to see in future videos. And before I let you guys go, let me give you the answer to that riddle. So, the riddle was, for anyone who may have forgotten, I speak without a mouth, I hear without ears, I have no body, but I come alive with the wind. What am I? The answer is an echo. I hope a lot of you guys out there got it, and if you didn't, I hope you enjoyed the little riddle. I hope you guys enjoyed tuning into these videos. That's all we have for you today. I'm your host, Chade Reyna, and I'm here to answer all your questions. Bye.